Hello friends, today we'll be discussing what are the worst foodstuffs for patients having hypertension. Hypertension is a condition where the overall blood pressure of the body is on the high side, because of which various organs and various tissue systems start to get damaged, because the increased pressure leads to damage of the vasculature and also of the various tissues of the body. This leads to various problems. We have discussed the various problems and complications of hypertension in various videos. Today we'll be discussing what are the foodstuffs which we should avoid. Before we go into the topic, I would request the people who are new to my channel to like the videos, to subscribe to my channel, to share the videos and to comment on the videos. So without wasting any time, let's dive deep into the video. First of all, salt or sodium is the most important thing which should be avoided in most patients having hypertension, because salt is the most important parameter which can lead to increase of blood pressure. Ideally, what is recommended that you have to reduce the total amount of salt intake to less than 2.3 grams per day. That is slightly less than a half for a small teaspoon. So very less amount of salt has to be used. And this includes whatever salt we are putting into our salads, our vegetables, our foodstuff, everything included, it should be less than 2.3 grams per day. Ideally speaking, it is very difficult to manage, because most of the people, especially who are taking Indian cuisine, everyone almost consumes 8 to 10 grams or 12 grams every day on a daily basis without adding extra amount of salt. Still, the total amount of salt which is put into most of the foodstuff is almost 8 to 12 grams per day. So if at all you want to curtail or reduce the amount of sodium intake, you not only need to reduce the extra salt or the table salt which you are taking on a daily basis, all the extra salt which you are adding to your salads and soups, you have to also reduce the amount of salt which you are adding to your vegetables and your other foodstuff also. Only then you will be able to probably meet the target, and then too it will be a very difficult job to reduce the total salt intake to less than 2.3 grams per day. Most of the people find it very difficult to do, especially with the kind of Indian cuisine which we are normally used to taking. Usually most of the things which contain good amount of salt are processed foods, canned soups, salty snacks, processed meats. All these contain large amount of salts, and especially any of the snack food like chips, pretzels, crackers, everything contain good amount of salt. So all this should be avoided if at all you want to curtail out the salt intake. Besides this, high sugar containing food products like beverages, soda, candy, ice cream products, baked food products, all these contain good amount of sugar. All this also lead to insulin resistance. Directly or indirectly, it affects the hypertension status of the body, and directly or indirectly, it leads to a lot of metabolic diseases. So any food products which contains good amount of sugar should be avoided. If at all you are wanting to cut down on your sugars, you can take some fresh foods, some unsweetened beverages, and some natural sweeteners like honey, maple syrup or stevia can be taken. But still, I would recommend that you should curtail or your sugar intake to the minimum possible, because in any form, even when you are taking fruit sugars, even when you are taking honey, it will cause some direct or indirect effects. So ideally, take as low amount of sugar as possible in the entire day. Then trans and saturated fat should be avoided, because a lot of fried food, junk food, high fatty food and processed foods containing trans fats are eaten by us on a daily basis. Most of these foods are not good for our health, and they will damage our heart and our kidney in a lot of ways. They also increase the inflammation inside the body and cause a lot of side effects inside the body. So trans fats in all forms should be avoided. In place of this, we can take healthy fats like olive oils, nuts, seeds and avocados, which contain some good unsaturated and healthy fats. Fish and fish oils can be taken, which contain omega-3 fatty acids. Alcohol should be avoided in all patients having significant hypertension, because hypertension can be worsened by patients who are taking alcohol, especially when they are taking a good quantity or large quantity of alcohol on a daily basis. Processed food and fast food containing sugars, unhealthy fats and large amount of salt and chemicals, all these increase the inflammation inside the body, so this should be avoided. Any foodstuff which contains vitamins, minerals, fibers and good amount of essential oils, all these are better for the patients and this should be taken. Processed and fast and junk food should be avoided, because in the long run they will increase the hypertension of the patient. Besides this, red meat which contains high amount of saturated fat, this also is not good for the cardiovascular patient. This will increase the chance of cardiovascular problem. So red meat should be avoided. Next is canned foods and vegetables which contains a large amount of salt and large amount of some processed chemicals. All these are also not good for the patient. They will increase the inflammation inside the body. In place of this, you can take fresh or frozen vegetables without any added chemicals, or you can take homemade soups, or you can take cooked beans or other protein-rich sources which are prepared in the home. Do not take any canned or processed foods which are available from the market. All these foodstuffs contain too much amount of preservatives. Pickles and olives, which are often used as condiments in sandwiches, salads and appetizers, all these also contain large amount of salt. this sodium intake might be detrimental for hypertensive patients, so this should be avoided. Sauces and gravies also contain good amount of trans fats and unhealthy fats and sodium, so also this should be avoided. Soya sauce, barbecue sauce, gravy sauce, creamy sauce, all these sauces contain good amount of sodium. They are very less in nutrients, they are very less in fiber content, so overall they increase the body weight and overall cardiovascular problems are also increased. So essentially all these things should be avoided. As far as possible, high fiber and nutrient containing food products should be preferred. White bread and pasta, which are prepared from refined flour, all these are ultra processed grains and all this increase the amount of inflammation inside the body. They contain very little amount of fiber, almost no fiber. So overall they are much more detrimental as compared to whole grains. So this should be avoided. They also increase our appetite. They also increase our hunger, and that is why they do obesity also. So in patients having obesity related problems also, they should be avoided. High fat dairy products which contain good amount of saturated fats, this also should be avoided. Whole milk, cream, cheese and a lot of other products containing good amount of saturated fats should be avoided. Lastly, any snacks which containing good amount of salts like chips, pretzels, crackers, nuts, everything should be avoided. These all, if at all they contain large amount of sodium, they contribute to increased blood pressure and contribute to weight gain. So overall, we should opt for a healthier snacks in the form of fresh fruits, vegetables and nuts, which are healthier options for patients having hypertension. So in this topic, we have discussed what are the food products which should be avoided in patients having significant hypertension. In other videos, we have discussed what are the food products which should be taken and preferred in patients having hypertension. Please check out on these videos as well. We have discussed what exactly is hypertension and what is the pathophysiology and other issues about hypertension. Also, please check these videos as well. Before we end the topic, the people who are new to my channel, I would request them to subscribe to my channel, to like the videos, to comment on the videos and to share the videos if possible.